All right, well, I guess I need to replace that intro video now because the car sounds different. So I don't know if I'll actually do that. I don't have a lot of time for these videos, but I try to do them. It's been about a month since I released that last video or something about my Centerline X-Pipe and some other mods that I did. And I was talking about how the Centerline X-Pipe was producing a whistle noise, or my exhaust system was producing a whistle noise, and couldn't really figure it out. I talked to Centerline about it. They didn't know what was up. I could not stand, after I did that video, I just like couldn't stand this problem, and I was just like, all right, I'm gonna fix this. And I took it into a muffler shop that I had been to before that I think helped me with another defective part of the muffler. I didn't think that it was a hanger on the X-pipe that was off and rubbing against the car and creating a vibration. I didn't blame Centerline for that. Because I wasn't sure. Now I blame Centerline for that because pretty much everything about the pipe was defective and we proved it, and Centerline actually hasn't gotten back to me, so that's a really bad look. And I messaged them over a month ago on that, so maybe it got lost. I'll give you guys the benefit of the doubt, but yeah, Centerline, not a great company for muffler parts, maybe. I don't know, because I'm not the only one who's had this experience. Now, I will say I still used the pipe, so it's not like the materials were a complete waste of money. I basically brought it back to the muffler shop. So if you're in the San Diego area, this muffler shop is called RPM, Richards Performance Muffler. I've gone to them twice. They are so friendly, so helpful, and professional, and fast, and it's just been a fantastic experience every time I've gone there. So highly recommend you check out RPM in Oceanside if you are in the San Diego area for any of your muffler exhaust needs, especially if it's something custom. Okay, so I replaced the X-pipe because I went into them, and I think it was Richard himself, I don't know, the owner of the shop, the main guy. We went on a little ride along and he was like, yeah, this sounds like it's probably the welds in the X-pipe. I can't say for sure, we'd have to take it apart, but yeah, it sounds like just some bad welds. So I can imagine, you know, you have some bad welds on the inside of an exhaust pipe and it's going to create some turbulence with the air, and you know, that's where the whistle comes from. So none of those are his words, that's just me assuming what's going on. He was like very straightforward, like, we don't know, but it sounds like the welds, we'll check on it. So they did surgery, they opened her up, and it was the welds, because they replaced the X-pipe. And also, I will say, I'm not the only person with this problem. The reason why I went this route and was able to fix this was because there were a couple other guys on here that had the same problem and had it replaced, like literally, especially one of them or both of them, right around the same exact time as me posting the video. So you guys are so helpful, thank you if that was you. Really gave me confidence going into fixing this. But yeah, so they did surgery. I decided, because we were kind of talking about it in the comments, I wanted to try out a straight pipe configuration. And I was kind of skeptical because I knew it would create a lot more raspiness and a lot more volume, and I really liked the tone of the other one, but I was like, yeah, let's see what happens. This could be really interesting. Plus it's a valve system, so I wouldn't have to deal with it all the time, so it's louder. We can still make it quiet, right? And that definitely happened. It is a lot louder. It is still really quiet with the valves closed. It's the same, which is amazing. I can't believe a car can be this loud and that this quiet at the same time. That's amazing. I want to talk about a few things with this. One, the sound, the characteristics of the sound, but also what happened when right after I did it. So I had some initial impressions I'm going to show you. And then also another mod that I did at the same time, which was I had them change out the muffler tips. So I went bold and I just had them straight cut off the stock exhaust muffler tips, because that was another cool thing about getting a full exhaust, cat-back exhaust. It's like the benefits didn't really seem to be there performance-wise to change out the full system, and it costs like $4,000 to $7,000, and really all you're getting is a change in sound and a change in look. So I changed the look and the sound for about $700 on top of the cost of the X-pipe, because I needed that material. But you don't necessarily have to do the X-pipe, you could just modify the stock exhaust too, and you'd get the same exact result because they're about the same. So I had them change out to slightly bigger tips. I'm gonna show you guys those. I actually love it. I didn't love it at first because I wasn't sure if they were perfect. And then as I adjusted to it, they look so much better on the car because they fill the space in the diffuser so much better. And once there's actually, it's funny, they're insulated tips, so like dual wall or double walled tips. So there's like a little bit of like a baffled or like wedge look to it. I'll show you. But once the carbon buildup inside of the tip turns it black, it actually looks even better than the stock and when it's clean. I find that very interesting because you're just getting like the outline, the bright outline tip in 4-inch tips, so proper sizing. It's a little bit smaller than if you've seen the, I think the Centerline full exhaust system. They look a little bit too big. These look proper size. They're about 1/2 inch smaller than that one. So I did the muffler tips. I did the straight pipe configuration of the exhaust, changed the sound, changed the volume. And now I'm gonna show you the sound and the initial impressions and everything. But the one thing I didn't discuss at first was like, I have a JB4 connected to the car. And so my car has been acting in different ways. Nothing bad, just every once in a while you have to let the tune kind of adjust. And I'm gonna make a video about that. Sorry it's been so long. I've actually been doing a lot of like testing with it and taking my time because there are some things that I needed to figure out before actually making a video about it. So I think I'm at that point where I can actually make a video about it with enough experience with it. So that's why we've been waiting, but I'm gonna make a JB4 video. But yeah, right when I put on the straight pipe, I was unsure about the sound. There were some certain things that sounded kind of weird, and the car definitely didn't appreciate the change in setup immediately. There was some like weird acceleration issues, nothing crazy, just like it felt really flat, really like it didn't want to go anywhere at first. Those smoothed out and I didn't really see a difference in performance. And now the car feels completely as good as it did before. Maybe a little better, but I don't know. We'll talk about that with the JB4 video because the car feels amazing right now, exactly how it is. But yeah, so the straight pipe definitely changed the way the computer was probably having to figure out different thingies that cars do. So yeah, let's listen to some stuff. All right, so I just picked up the car from getting the straight pipes done. Initial impression was that it definitely sounds a lot different, but if you can hear it, it's got these like, when it kicks in, it's got a raspy amount of raspiness and volume that is way more intense than just the X pipe. And sorry about this view, I don't have my stand thing, but it is so loud. But in natural or with the valves closed, it's actually still just as quiet with no drone. But it sounds amazing. Okay, so another thing I'm noticing is that the amount of throttle affects the noise. And maybe that's a boosted engine type of thing, but if I hold off on some of the throttle, I can hold this raspiness. And it's like real loud. And then if I go more into boost, it numbs out and gets very like hollow. And you know, you hear that surge and more turbo spool and stuff like that, but you don't get that raspiness. That's very interesting to me. And I kind of like that too, because it means if I want more noise, I don't have to go absurdly illegal speeds or get to absurdly illegal speeds really fast and just kind of, you know, drive a little bit slower. All right, so I had them put on 4-inch tips, and I don't think it's too big, but you see a lot more of the inside because they're those double layer insulated tips. Whatever you call those. I don't know, like or dislike. It looks great, it's just I think they're a little pronounced. They're not too far out. They're placed properly, but
I don't know. Maybe because they're silver and everything else is blacked out, maybe I should spray paint them black.
Inside sounds exactly the same. And what I meant by like the black on the inside of the tip was this: when the wall, inner wall of the tip is blackened, I think it looks a lot better than stock. I really like that look. But what you could hear from the videos and stuff is like the extra noises that you get from this setup, car drive by, are insane. They're like, you get so much more character out of the car, and you get those like in between shift pops every single shift, and they're always a little bit different. Sometimes they're like a good fart, you know, and then sometimes they're just like a crack. But the car is so much more fun to drive even without driving faster. That was the cool thing. It's like I get way more sound and characteristic out of the car without having to drive a lot faster, which is really dope. I think the only thing left to say is you should do this. You should straight pipe your Alfa Romeo. It sounds amazing, but it is pretty loud. It can be a little bit obnoxious. I still haven't heard the car from outside of the car myself, like a drive-by, so I'm gonna have someone do that for me. I think either the X-pipe or the straight pipe setup is the best way to go to get more sound and fun out of your Alfa Romeo. I wouldn't go with the Centerline X-pipe. Like, I don't put it past them, like, as if, like, they should never have a defective product or a problem with their product. That wouldn't be fair. But I think they should communicate with their customers and own up to defects. So if they don't end up doing that, then I don't think it's a great company. But, you know, you could go with that. There's always a fix. Or you could just have a muffler shop cut up your OEM center pipe and put the same X pipe or straight pipe configuration with the same noise, the same product, except for it'll actually probably be better because it fits a little bit better in the center line. I won't go into that, but there's some issues with, you know, the fit and a little bit of leaky gasket because it's just like a pipe on pipe fit, and the stock exhaust actually has a little like bump to help with the fitting that the aftermarket pipe doesn't have. So if you were to cut up your OEM pipe, you could actually order one for probably about the same price if you needed a stock pipe back on for as the Centerline X pipe. So I don't think the Centerline X pipe is really that worth it if you have to fix it to use it anyways. But otherwise, yeah, I will produce some more content with more noise. I'm gonna try to get better exhaust sound. I don't have proper mic or anything for this, but it sounds so dope. Definitely worth it. And next thing up, I'm gonna do is the JB4 and diving into that tuning module.